Just like Bigfoot, there is more myth than reality in what most people think preppers are. The media has done a great job of making preppers look foolish and dangerous when the reality is far from it. The idea of prepping is a very basic concept. It is simply wanting to be ready for an emergency. Although there are some who have something very specific in mind, most are not of that mindset. So let's take a look at some of the misconceptions about the average prepper. In no particular order. Number one, preppers are religious fanatics. A lot of people seem to be under the impression that preppers are religious zealots who scream on street corners about God and the apocalypse. And although there are many preppers who are religious or may prep for religious reasons, that does not mean that they go about screaming about the wrath of God. And the ones who do by no means represent the majority of preppers. Number two, preppers expect the apocalypse. Not true. Many preppers are not preparing for or expecting a global apocalypse. Most preppers are just simple folks who want to be ahead of the game just in case they were in an emergency. They are the people who live in a tornado zone and want to be ready for a tornado. Or they are the people who live in a flood zone and want to be ready for a flood. They are the people who have some extra food and water, just in case there is an event that cuts the community off from access to food and water. Kind of like what happened in Puerto Rico. Kind of like what's still happening in Puerto Rico.
Even right now, look at the current virus situation and how people have acted and overreacted. Look at the empty shelves in the supermarkets. These are people that were not ready, and had they been prepared, would not be in the situation that they're in now.
Number three, preppers are conspiracy theorists. Largely thanks to the media, most non-prepper individuals are of the impression that preppers are paranoid lunatics who believe the Earth has been secretly taken over by aliens, or that every time something is out of place in their home, it means they shifted into another dimension. And once again, nothing could be farther from the truth. The majority of preppers are just people who want to be ready in case an emergency comes up. Number four, preppers are isolated. Again, thanks to the media, many people are under the impression that preppers are all a bunch of crazy hermits with a severe case of cabin fever, hiding out in the woods ready to shoot anything that moves. And once again, this simply isn't true. Many preppers are just like the average person. As a matter of fact, he could be your next door neighbor and you'd never even know it, because he's that normal. And number five, preppers are all white and racist. There are a lot of people who seem to think that all preppers are evil skinheads who prep by day and burn crosses by night. And I'll tell you, I've known a bunch of preppers, and I am as of yet to meet a racist one. And I have known several who were not white. And if you've been watching enough of my videos, you know that I had to add one more. Call it number six, if you will. Preppers want the apocalypse. Now, whereas there are a small majority of preppers who believe that the whole world is in need of a reset, that doesn't necessarily mean that they want it. Preppers who want to see the whole world burn do not speak for the majority of preppers. So for those of you who are not preppers and viewed this video out of curiosity, I hope it helped open your mind, even just a little. Don't believe everything you see in the media. Research things for yourself. Most preppers are just people who want to be ready in times of crisis. Or don't you have a smoke detector, and in many cases even a fire extinguisher in your home? Is that not prepping for a fire? Same concept, folks. Or how about that spare tire that you have in the back of your car? If you don't believe in preppers, maybe you should get rid of it. And for those of you who are preppers, if there's anything you would like to add to the list, feel free to post it in the comment section down below. Do give it a thumbs up and share it if you can. If you got anything out of the video, it would sure help. If you're new to the channel, do take the time to subscribe and check out some of the other video content. You may find something interesting. Remember that I can also be found on another YouTube channel called Coffee Talk. I'll put a link to that in the description. So as always, stay frosty, folks, and thanks for watching.